Hey you guys, so I just wanted to come on here and let you guys know about a training opportunity that I saw on my LinkedIn. If you guys do not have LinkedIn, you guys should get LinkedIn. It's an excellent tool to network, to find out who's hiring, and to find jobs, just job hunt. It's so much easier to apply for a job on LinkedIn. It's just easy. And then you get a chance to see who actually works for the company. You can see the recruiters, you can see the managers, just everything. Anyway, I saw this opportunity on LinkedIn and I thought I would share it with you guys. So it is an apprenticeship. It is an apprenticeship program with OS2 Healthcare Solutions. It's 20 weeks. You have to give them 20 weeks of your time. It is paid. I'm not sure at which point it's paid. I know there is like a coding assessment period where they see if you can handle the coding world, you know? I know you do have to set up a 30 minutes or more conversation with Ms. Freeman or her staff to talk with them to make sure that this is something you can accomplish, get done, and something you're willing to invest in. Because even though it's paid, you do have to have equipment. You do have to have a computer. You do have to have, or you know, some type of laptop or a computer. Connection, you have to be connected to the Wi-Fi. And you also need to make sure that you have coding books. And for some people, that's an expensive investment. I know some contract companies do not provide equipment, and that's something that you will need to provide for yourself. So keep that in mind. Just because they're asking you to do it doesn't mean they're asking you for a reason. Some contract companies do not provide those things to their coders, so keep that in mind. Also, so after the 20 weeks and you speak to her and everything, I know there's a few different types of apprenticeships. And the one that I did look at was one for the RHIT, someone who holds RHIT credentials, so that's an option, or CCS, or CCA, any credential from AHIMA, and then people who don't hold any credentials who are just getting into the field. This will help you obtain the CRC, which is the Certified Risk Adjustment Coder thing, credential, which is HCC, Hierarchy Condition Coding. I'm not really sure what that acronym stands for. Anyway, it's for risk adjustment. That's an AAPC credential. So I am not really sure what it all details, because I do not hold that credential. I've never really looked into it. I know it is risk adjustment, and I know there is risk adjustment season. They do look for a lot of risk adjustment coders or HCC coders. And I know right now the market is hot for HCC coders. They want you guys, they're looking for you guys, and I think this is a good way to like get your foot in the door, to get the training that you need, and hopefully upgrade. Now, I'm not sure how much the paid apprenticeship is. I wouldn't say, just me being realistic about the job market right now, and coming in as a new coder at 2019, and this being an apprenticeship, I would not say that it's going to be top dollar. It's probably not. It's probably going to be minimum wage. Okay? It's probably going to be minimum wage. But that's okay. We just need to get our feet. You just need to get your feet underneath you. Learn what you need to learn. And then, move on if that's what you want to do. I know this program does offer employment for their, top candidate coders. They do really well and all of that stuff. And they do have like help with job placement. So if this is something you're looking into, check the link in the description box. I'm gonna post the website so you can check out our apprenticeship program. But I thought it was an awesome opportunity for those of you who wanna get into the coding field but don't know how to break in, or are having trouble getting your foot in through the door at a facility, hospital, LTAC, whatever. Okay? So yeah. All right, let me know what you guys think. Okay, if you guys decide to do the apprenticeship program, let me know how it goes, because I'm kind of curious. I've been looking at risk adjustment, but I haven't been too sure if I want to take that leap or go in that direction. Okay, bye y'all.